But there's one event that worries me more than any other. I did my training kayaking the bitches in extreme white water in Wales. That improved my paddling skills, but the boats themselves were very different. And I've never even set foot in a racing ocean kayak before.
That is very wobbly, Grant.
So Grant has agreed to give me some last-minute coaching and lends me a fast and very narrow racing kayak. These kayaks are built for speed, and the experienced pro can slice through the water at speeds of over 20 kilometres per hour. The trouble is, for a novice like me, it's hard to keep upright, let alone pick up any speed.
I think I'm going to be used to doing that, something
tells
me.
Skill, or you've got to get it back.
I tell you, this is going to be a very long leg. Okay. Getting there, I'm just getting used to getting in and out, Grant.
After a couple of hours, I finally start to gain some confidence.
You look like you're settling in.
Yeah, I'm still fighting the balance.
Yep.
Which I think is what's going to tire me out more than the paddling.
Very much so.
It's a daunting prospect to think that in less than 24 hours, I'll be in this kayak in a 13-kilometre race in choppy seas. But I'm not prepared to give up. My struggle is as much about mental preparation as it is physical.
One of the best things you can learn in life is just to parcel up little things in your mind and just open them when you need them. And that's how I get through lots of things in life, whether it's a 700-mile trek to the South Pole on skis, whether it's a 7 or 8 day trek across the Sahara Desert. If you look at the big picture, you'll be overwhelmed by it and you'll just chuck it all in and go, I can't do it. And you'll go back and lie on your sofa and have a cup of tea. But how boring would life be like that?